Hello and welcome to 9design 3D. Today I will show you how to transfer high poly mesh details onto low poly mesh using with multi-res modifier and normal map bake methods. I am slowly thinking that it's time to switch to Unreal Engine, and frankly sometimes even I forgot what I'm doing too, and I need to watch my own tutorial videos. I'm recording a detail transfer video, which is an important topic, and we will see this today. Let's go to the tutorial. I will make a gold vase for this tutorial, so first we will add a circle for our scene, and after that E to extrude in Z axis and E to extrude right click and S to scale. Again, as the same method pattern, you can use this E to extrusion, S to scale for making this vase type. For the top, you can E to extrude it down again and F to fill. Before all of this, if you want to add some details on your low poly mesh too, you can add extra loop cut with Ctrl R. After give you shape, don't forget to F to fill top and down. Now we will add some mark seam with the right click for choosing some around our circular part. With the choosing some vertical part too, and you can add mark seam to detail for this, or adding some mark sharp details for the top and bottom parts. In the UV edit tab, you can choose all of it with A and U to unwrap. As you see, it can be a bit stretch. So if you want, you can use a other method for this too, U and Smart UV project. It will work fine. If you want, you can use this for all details, making our normal map smoothly. Before all of this, check your wireframe. We will add some multi-res modifier from our modifier tab and subdivide it 4 times. Don't forget to uncheck your optimal display. As you see, it is too dense. Go to sculpting and choose your draw brush. After that, under the texture, press new button. From the left menu, you can open your alpha texture. I will leave link in description. I downloaded this sun pattern. Under the follow, as you see many species in here, choose constant. And under the symmetry part, you can set up your radial ZY for the roundy repeated pattern. With the pressing F, you can scale your alpha brush like that, and after that press onto your vase, it will give a alpha textures shape like that. Again pressing F, you can scale your sun pattern, and with the left click you can edit onto your vase. Under the brush tools, with the direction add or subtract and strength radius, you can set brush species from here. And with the smooth brush, and don't forget to decrease your strength, you can give a bit of smoothness for your new sculpting patterns. And turn back to the layout. Before shading, we will decrease our level viewport to 0 and go to shading. Now we will add a new material in here. I will type it vase gold. And with the hex code, you can find something from the Google. I will make it gold type. I am increasing my metallic one and decreasing my roughness a bit. After that, we will add an image texture in here. With the pressing new button, type your normal map name, and after that, don't forget to check your width and height as a 4K. And press OK. And the color space, don't forget to check it as a non-color. Now from the left texture part, choose your normal as we created new, and under the render, don't forget to choose the cycles too. Under the bake settings, check your bake from multi-res and bake type will be normals. And when you image selected, press bake. And you can save as your normal map. Now we will add some normal map node in here. Connect your normal maps normal to principles normal and your image color to normal map color. As you see, This is low poly, but our texture is looking like high poly details. In the layout, in the object mode, you can see something on it. When you go to shading and viewport, you can see your details on your golden vase. In some part of maybe temple or other type of game assets, you can use this normals like that and baking other ambient occlusion base color type of the baking your textures. You can use this method or transfer your some object or some environment part to the game engines. As I said before, we will learn some Blender and Unreal Engine connection for the game assets or environment part. I will make some tutorial it for too. But before all of this, I want to show how to transfer your high poly details to your low poly meshes, because it's really good work for the games and cinematics. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.